Why you have to be gangster about getting your money? Right now, being too nice, being too friendly, being too accommodating is not the way for you to get money. One of the things is, I know that this will be contrary to what all the stuff that you should hear online, that you should give value. You should give value. And I'm here to tell you that doesn't work. One of the ways to get money is to be gangster about getting your money. With Disruptive Mail, each video had an embedded call to action, and the channel was making $14,000, $17,000 a month. Not a lot of subscribers, but it was that consistent pig-headed determination that was bringing in the money. Now, one of the things that I did with Savage Finance was I built the channel first, and then I'm about to start doing the calls to actions in the videos, and I'm about to start doing 4 videos a week, perhaps, I don't know, but you've got to be gangster about getting your money. You've got to be, give me all your money, seriously. Because all of that nice stuff, all of that namby-pamby, I'm giving you value, I'm posting all of this stuff on Facebook, I'm posting all of this stuff on the blog, it don't work. It doesn't work. One of the things that you have to do is ask directly for the money. Similarly, from a dating standpoint, when you ask directly for the booty, you get more booty. And when you ask directly for the money, you get more money. So this is one of the things. I want you to start practicing financial self-defense. I want you to start asking for the money, because a closed mouth doesn't get fed. And this is one of the things that I see throughout the internet space that is consistently wrong. Don't ask for the money. Just offer, just hope that people will. Let's say you're a dude and there's this sexy girl that you're friends with and you want to smash, and you never ever ask her for the booty. Never ask her. You go out on dates with her, you help her move, and you just one day, you know, you hoping and praying that she's gonna bless you with some booty, and it never happens. Then she meet Jerome or Tyrone, next thing you know, and then she's telling you about how Jerome or Tyrone beat it up and how you're like, I've been here for months. I've been your boo thing. But how come you didn't give me any booty? Because you didn't ask. See, Tyrone and Jerome, they asked for the booty. And the people who asked for the money, like right now, there's a whole bunch of stuff going on about Grant Cardone. How often does Grant Cardone ask for the money? Every time it's like, hey, you need to invest in Cardone Capital. You need to invest in, he goes over and over again. And all of these people who are way poorer than him, who have no damn money. Well, Grant Cardone and Cardone Capital is a bad investment, blah, blah, blah. Grant. They never ever actually talk about the $150 million a year he makes from his e-commerce business. It's all about Grant Cardone Capital. Grant has built his own economy. Grant asked for the money. Hey, you need to invest in Cardone Capital. We're getting ready to open the... He's consistently asking for the money. And you see all of these people who are afraid to ask for the money. They don't have no money. There's this one guy who's been talking smack about Grant. He wrote a bad check to his hard money lender, hoping and praying that he would somehow scratch up the money before that check got to his hard money lender. And he's poking holes. See, he never, because this is one of the things that happens with many of these little channels that, you know, the fake, they don't ask for the money. They're afraid to ask for the money. They have been socialized that asking for money is bad. You need to ask for the money. You have a product or service, you need to ask for the money. You need to come up with a price, name your price, and ask for their money over and over and over and over again. Because if you don't ask for the money, and this is one of the things that happens, I remember years ago, I sold this lady some office furniture. She had rented her office, she had got her furniture, she had built everything. She had no customers. 18 months later, she went out of business because she ran out of money. Because she wasn't asking nobody for the money. You got to ask for the money. And like right now, for all these credit folks, like tomorrow, I'm going to have a video. It's going to be like, would you rather have an 850 credit score or would you rather have $100,000 cash? I'm going to break that down. Because right now, asking for credit in this current environment, a friend of mine called me and he said, you understand American Express just closed all my accounts. Person has a 780 credit score. And he's just like, he wasn't using, you know, he wasn't using his American Express card. So they shut him off. Never late. No bad stuff. He didn't lie about income. So asking for the cash money that you could put in your bank account. How many people had a bank account closed because they had too much cash in it? It's never happened. But you can lose your credit cards because you have too much credit per the bank's internal scoring models. They're like, ah, this person looking kind of risky, so we're going to cut him off. You ain't done nothing wrong. You have not missed a payment. And they are getting rid of your credit. So this is another reason you need to be about your cash money. You need to have cash money in the bank. You need to be getting cash money. You need to walk in there like a gangster. Give me all your money. And say it over and over again. Be loud and proud about it because you got to ask for the money. And this is one of the things that I see online that's like, give value. Just give value. Just keep showing up. Just keep working. Keep doing double monkey backflips and all of this other stuff. And one day, they're going to reciprocate. None ain't. This is one of my biggest issues with Gary Vee. I have done this. I have given away stuff for good, and it backfired on me. So this is what I know. I'm not speaking from assumption. I'm speaking from experience. Ask for the money. Go ahead. Ask for the money. Give me the money over and over and over again. This is part of your sales process, where you're consistently asking the consumer for the money. You got to do this. You got to consistently do this. So tomorrow, 7 p.m., I'm going to have a live webinar, how to make money from scratch. And it will be about how to retrain yourself, how to set up yourself to make it in the new economy, and how to re-socialize yourself. Because there are so many people. Like I said, there are all these channels who are like, hey, fake gurus, because they're asking for the money. And these folks don't have the courage to ask for the money. And a lot of these folks who are poking holes and all this other stuff, they're broke. They have no money. So go below, sign up for the live webinar. It's going to be 7 p.m. Sunday. And I'm going to break down a lot of stuff. And I'm going to help you learn how to ask for the money, because believe it or not, the way you were raised could interfere with you making money in the future. It is so crazy how we have been socialized that asking for money is bad. We've been socialized that promoting yourself is bad. All of these things that get in the way of you making money. How many of you would like to be Grant Cardone? Because a lot of people are like, oh, I hate Grant. I hate Grant. Grant got millions of dollars in cash money in the bank. Millions. Because he asked for the money. And a lot of people hate the fact that he asked for the money. So one of the things that you've got to understand is you got to play the game the right way and not the way that you think you should play the game. So ask for the money. Go below. Get the course. There's a lot there, and I'm going to give you a little discount, a little juice off, and I will see you tomorrow at 7 p.m. So watch this next video. It's going to be right here.